Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to have a little bit of a rotate, and we're going to take a minute to get a little bit of a state on the course. Welcome to the third division change in the city board and report of our leadership of the city of Rainey. And welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the board and including the team. Today's ceremony, we're going to see the practicing the protocol on 1775. The purpose of the band represents the significant role of Washington in spreading our history, our instilling pride, loyalty, and courage in all people who are ahead. The formation of troops that are on the national flag represents the human conquest of our army and its willingness to make all the sacrifices in defense of our nation. Next to our national flag are our unit colors. This closes the national flag symbolizing trust placing the entire nation. Before this unit is created in the county colors, each is a symbol of pride, tradition, and history. Unit colors still serve as mark for location and organization headquarters and its commander. When the unit colors are removed from the headquarters, such as the today's ceremony, they will remain under guard. This is more than tradition. It is silent recognition and devotion to the sacrifice and gallantry of all who have ever served under those colors. The task of guarding unit colors is an honor to its own finest of soldiers. Ladies and gentlemen, our special guests in today's ceremony include General Robert A. Abrams, Commander of United States Armed Forces Command in the States. Adam Brown, Mayor of Huntington. William Austin, Mayor of Roseboro. Clementine Washington, Mayor of Midland. Terry Branch, Mayor of Claxton and Mrs. Branch. Lieutenant General Stephen Dewey, Commanding General of the 1st United States Army. Lieutenant General Retired John Ocean and Mrs. Ocean. Lieutenant General Retired Robert Lennox. Lieutenant General Retired Robert Sullivan and Mrs. Sullivan. Mr. Craig Carter, House Armed Forces Service Committee, Radius Subcommittee, Lead Staff Member. Major General Michael Carrillo, Commanding General of 82nd Airborne Infantry Division. Major General John Quintas, the Deputy Director of Political and Military Affairs and Joint Staff. Major General Joe Girard, the Adjutant General of the Georgia and Infantry Division. Major General James Brown, the United States Army Forces Command, Deputy Commanding General of the Army National Guard. Major General Dan McCarty, the Deputy Adjutant General of South Carolina. Major General Jim Murray, the outgoing Commanding General of the 3rd Infantry Division and Infantry Division. Major General Leopoldo Quintas, the incoming Commanding General of the 3rd Infantry Division and Infantry Division. Major General Retired William Rimsley, this is Major General The soldiers on the field represent all Broadway soldiers and every company assigned to the 3rd Infantry Division, Rock and Roll. We hope you enjoy this special event. On behalf of the soldiers and families of the 3rd Infantry Division, red roses and gold blue are now being presented to the 3rd Army, as well as the similar roses to their daughters, Bailey and Jenny, and the division symbolizing the appreciation and support contributions made by our movement.
Thank you. all day for over 20 years for every day, and now you're ready to start on training.
And in other case, any time you can pray. In your name, in your name, amen. Amen. Please be seated. The division action and major issue approved will now work with the viewers. The sound of the sanctuary. Throughout history, commanders have used music to raise morale and spirit of their soldiers before battle with patriotic songs and stern marches. Today, it is still civilized in ceremonies such as this, as long band prepares to parade before the soldiers of the division. Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the pride of the Armed Division, the best division band in the land, the 3rd Infantry Division Band, and as they execute, sound off.
Thank you.
decision that we please stand for our next steward officer. Today, General Abrams has poured hours of soldiers and families into with our individual. The review program has developed an exceptional troops. Shoot them on the line. This is how our tradition allows the man to respect the purpose and loyalty of the soldiers while providing soldiers the opportunity to meet their time in our force. The troops should have demanded their hostile burdens, devotional duty, and willingness to carry out their mission. The third of these traditions that is a coastal, fourth bank, and much longer than Victoria. It is currently organized in the 3-8 combat teams, 1 aviation grade, and support islands. The division votes the soldiers for the battle of service in World War I, World War II, Korea, Operation Desert Storm, Operation Barrage, and Vietnam, and Operation Red Bull. This outstanding combat effort has earned a high cost of more than 50,000 wartime casualties. 55 members of the 3rd Division have been awarded the Medal of Honor, more than any other division. The 3rd Division activated on 21 November 1970 at Camp Murray, North Carolina. 8 months later, saw the first combat in France. And beginning on 14th July 1980, the division earned the 7th Battle of the Marne. The division Brigade were rushed to attack at 370 to form a jam in the middle of the offensive in the past. While surrounding the 3rd Division, the United States 1st Division, Major General Joseph T. Newton, called his first commander in the middle of the town, New Restaurant Block, with his safety. And she was the division of the Marne, helping her take and her rock and arm. Service for 200 of the division were won the Medal of Honor. During World War II, the 3rd Division was one of the few American divisions that fought the acts of all from the American leaders, and was one of the first men of combat units to remain in our 50-ground combat operations. The 3rd Division was one of the 7th Marines as part of the 3rd Division, where they were captured in the city of Augsburg, Munich, and was in the vicinity of Salzburg, Austria, in the World War II. The 3rd Division suffered one combat force in World War II and the U.S. Division. By the end of World War II, the Dark Prince Corps was able to be 37 medals of honor, including Sergeant Martin Murphy, who only became a decorated sergeant. During the Korean War, the entire division moved to Iron Mountain to guard the leading place in support of the withdrawal of the 1st Marine Division and the Regiment Combat Team 31 to the City of Rose Bowl. 30th Division was a rear car keeping the pressure off the Marine Column. Dark Prince Corps was the fourth quarter final to the Army and the Museum facilities at a rise of 7th, indicating the 64th Engineering and the 4th ships. The division went on to support combat missions in the 8th Army until 1933 when it was withdrawn. Throughout the war, the division fought 19 receiving 10 battle stars and 11 more Medal of Honor recipients to the division's list of heroes. From April 1958 to April 1996, the Marne Division was stationed with the 7th Corps of West Germany from near Chickenborough, westward throughout various towns, including Würzburg, Freiburg, Kitzingen, and Aschaffenburg. In August 1961, he attacked the Northern Wall Directive, a reinforced company in the 7th Infantry Regiment in full battle view, was ordered to West Berlin to assert the right of U.S. forces to declare an unhindered in East Germany to West Berlin. In November 1990, soldiers of the 3rd Infantry were once again involved in action. Following that action, the Regiment of Germany ordered 6,000 lost soldiers to the 3rd Division to form part of Operation Bergstrom. Later, the 1,000 soldiers that were attacked in the 3rd Division in Iraq were the 6th Turkish Regiment. On 15 February 1996, the 24th Infantry Division were reactivated and reflagged to become the 3rd Infantry Division at Fort Sioux, Fort Bend, and Prince Royal Field Soldiers. The division repeatedly demonstrated values in all the nation by deploying teams to Kuwait, Egypt, Bosnia, and Kosovo, and partnership tournament in East Division. In 2003, all the division of 1974 demonstrated a vanguard of U.S. forces supported to defeat the Bosnian forces on the Great River Valley. The Kurdish division crossed heavily in the capital, over which the Saddam International Airport and Saddam Al-Fall Palace on the western side of Baghdad in the first days of April. At the end of that airport, our first class all last year, our division turned up the lines during the war, which is extraordinary battle, and the first of all, the anti-terror threat is single-handed. 7 years later, the 7th day, and 2 day recovery on the middle of Baghdad, the Dawson soldiers inside the city held a copy of the Saddam Hussein strategy, signifying a dictator's defeat, no doubt, and all the other ones are being torn apart. Following the fall of the division agreement, the Royal Army and Baghdad and Akbar provinces, the division returned to the United States in August 2004. In 2004, the 3rd Infantry Division was reorganized as part of an army transformation to become the 1st modular division. In January 75, during the 2nd tour in Iraq, the division's forces transitioned to battle strategy operations to serve the foundation to modern insurance. These efforts set conditions to establish a new democratic Iraq government. The division reported the first source for them in January 2006. By early 2007, the entire division of the Tampa Act called the search. We want to serve the division force of past members of the Iraqi security networks that were numerous deployments throughout the area and assisted Iraq's new government in the efforts to save life and country. The division headquarters is headquartered in the United States in May 2008. In 2009 and 2010, the first division became the headquarters of the Empire State in the Baghdad, Northern Iraq, and Afghanistan. This support marked the first time the division headquartered in Iraq. indivisible, liberty, and resilience of the past, we stand as guardians of the present, and serve to inspire and celebrate the loyalty, duty, and courage to achieve victory in the future. Please pass the governor's service of our country's soldiers from the smoke and fall of the battle. Today, I was on the symbol of the union and the company of America, wherever we may go. The change of command is a simple thing that is rooted in tradition, symbolism, and heritage. Key to the ceremony, the past will be the colors. The colors of the tremendous symbol of code representing the responsibility to the organization, wherever the commander is, and also on his colors. The custodian of the colors is the command sergeant major, the senior is the soldier of the year, and the principal advisor is the commander. The past of the colors symbolize the transfer of authority from the outgoing commander to the incoming commander. The passing of the colors demonstrates the soldiers of the unit, the old commander has passed the ranks of leadership to the new commander, and with this must also pass the loyalty of the soldiers to the new commander. By the Code of Army Regulation 600-20, paragraph 2-10, the undersigned seems to marry the 3rd Infantry Division, effective 08-May-2017, signed Leopoldo Quintas, Jr., Major General Commander. Command Sergeant Major of the Guard will not pass the colors in the general rank as the Division Command Sergeant Major. Major General Rainey now passes the colors in general labor of the City Colony to the Division of Command and Institution of 23 months as the Commanding General of the 3rd Infantry Division. General Rainey passes the colors in the General Quintas, charging with the responsibility of the 3rd Infantry Division as its new Commanding General. Major General Quintas passes the colors of the Division Command Sergeant Major, Command Sergeant Major Gallagher, the senior as the leader and the keeper of his colors. Ladies and gentlemen, the Commanding General of the United States Army Forces Command, General Robert A. Abrams.
Support previous and get here in the near future. It is fitting that we are conducting the ceremony of the so-called Warriors Walk. Hallowed ground for sons and families of our nation. We are surrounded by the memories of heroes of this generation of God's great soldiers, personified by the 468 White Queen Rainey Murder Trees, painted the coast of Florida. These beautiful trees are living monuments of God's great soldiers who made the ultimate sacrifice to defend our country, our ideals, our beliefs. And while they are gone, they will never be forgotten. Over the past 2 years, the Army has been training and deploying at a rapid pace under the leadership of the Division Commander, Major General Rainey, including deployment of the Division Headquarters in Afghanistan as a Resolution Support Master Support Element and a Mission Command Element for the Office of Important Training Class and Citizen Command East. The Division also executed relocations from the main level, regional allied operating forces to Europe and Africa. Conducting exercise, security cooperation activities to reach our allies and deter possible foes. While training and combat forces to the Combat Command Security Division completed the simultaneous evacuation of the 3rd Armored Brigade Combat Team, the 2nd Armored Brigade, and 4th Regiment, the Staff of the Standard Force. This organization required the divestiture of hundreds of thousands of military combatants out of the whole $1 million range, and the success of rebuilding of a light armor covers modernized equipment for citizens. All of these successes, every single one and more, were only possible due to the outstanding soldiers of the 3rd Infantry Division. This division is full of high-performing soldiers. They're tactically, proficient. They're dedicated to their profession, and they are committed to accomplish any mission to a very high standard. Today, I defer a ceremony of honor to the soldiers and families of the 3rd Infantry Division. It is those soldiers who make it all happen, both deployed and in home stage. It is their families who shoulder the heavy load, continue to sacrifice in service to their country. So please join me in a round of applause and recognize our great soldiers and families of the 3rd Infantry Division. Of the soldiers and families of the 3rd Infantry Division who have had a better leader during the last 2 years than General Rainey, who is one of our Army's premier war fighters and trainers. Throughout his adaptation operations, he has struck a balance of tough, realistic training with genuine care for soldiers and families, and General Rainey has led from the front. Under his leadership, General Rainey integrated the Division's public training program. The purpose and the assumption of rapid deployment missions. The 3rd Infantry Division Headquarters has set up a standard for sustaining true warfighting proficiency and is ready to fight tonight. The assessment of this leadership, the 3rd Infantry Division is a tactically competent, cohesive team of warfighters led by skilled, versatile, agile leaders. That's what it means to be able to face all. Under Chief Personal Leadership, the Division also set an arc to strengthen the readiness of our civil army through the implementation of the Associated Unit Pilot Program. Our British Captain George and Joe Gerard, you heard introduced by the narrator, his presence today, the presence of the colors of the very 48 Infantry Brigade Pilot team on the field, is testimony to Jim Rainey's leadership. Today, the 3rd Infantry Division is one of three joining the Army units to have an Army National Guard Brigade Combat Team associated with it. Together, the Corps National Guard and the 48th Infantry Brigade Combat Team and the 3rd Infantry Division are leading the Army in what our life looks like in Cold War generation. But the next ceremony is more than just the transition of commanders. The leaders and soldiers of the 3rd Infantry Division bid for a role today at Team Marine. So, Tracy, thank you. Thank you for everything you've done for the soldiers and families of the division. Like our families know that Tracy Rainey has been an epitome of her own spouse, always volunteering, always giving so much to her community. As a current division member of the Red Troop, senior status advisor, and a key member of the Army Chief's Spouse Club, she wants community support Another step of our task holds of bands. First, the mission comes to set us men and many other steps. Probably not more important than more short of training there to hit by hurricane and fastball and answer tornado. Our personal efforts to energize Red Cross and other nonprofit organizations work for those affected with the dedication of selfless service. She made meaningful difference to lives of so many. Senator Tracy, thank you for all of you on the 3rd Infantry Division and 4th Tour in the past few years. I wish you nothing but success. The ship has all the Pentagon. The deputy, and the evening of the game, I'm making sure we need more equipment for our nose train and for the 3rd Infantry Division. So, equipment to be answered as a lieutenant in the 3rd Infantry Division's Army. And once that I've served in the Division of Air Corps Corps, as the Division Chief said, I know there's a lot of equipment to decide to take away today. But part of that time is also a direct reflection of the fact that he managed to achieve the confines of the Bond and Fortune headquarters, where we have been rolling hard as Fortune C357. But there is no one, and I mean no one, in our army that has ever cared to undertake the more restraining of values to love of the guns, to understand souls and families as a passion for it, than we Quintas. We welcome the front of the service to this division, and expect that passion for those families to be elevated, the courage to be given to new heights. Now, I'd like to remind you that if you ever believe you're going to need an army, then you better have a good one, and it better be ready. Today, there are 187,000 soldiers. Think about that. 187,000 soldiers that have been deployed or forward stations around the world in over 80 countries. They are on watch today for you, for me, so that we can enjoy our freedoms. Please keep them and their families in your prayers. To the soldiers, civilian families, the 3rd Infantry Division, and 4th Corps, and our closest border communities, this morning. Thank you. Thank you for all that you do for our army and for our nation. God bless.
Thank you for making work, I like support, love.
family, friendships, all the men and women in this country, and that's freedom. So I'll close by thanking the men and women who made us free. Serving the tag, the Roy Carroll, you know how I feel about you. This is all the man, I think serving the tag is the number one and the one we truly hold. Cities have become generals. Field here, and like earlier was said, I'm like 468 trees on your climbs. You are absolutely the very best, and everything good is on your back. Thank you so much. It's been an honor to serve with you and follow the Bob Boys over. God bless you, Rock and Roll.
Ladies and gentlemen, the first Infantry Division, Major General Leopoldo Quintas, Jr.
Good morning, everyone. I'm out for a special welcome to our clinic visitors, fellows, and other thanks for being here and appreciating what we set up this cool ceremony. I want to offer a special shout out to some of the special visitors that have come to work with this team to command to attend to our setup quickly. On my first opportunity today, when I was DCG for the next day of your day, to Penitent Cutter Alvarez, who was in the Army GA, saw fit to release me from the Pentagon to become a chief of staff of the 3rd Division. Sir, I know you did that. Thank you. Penitent Cutter Alvarez, my sincere, the Deputy Commanding General of Force, who taught me so much about the Coat of Arms and especially about our Army National Guard. So thank you, Daniel. General Joe Gerard, our Georgia tag, I look forward to talking with you and joining readiness for the 48th Infantry Combat Team and the 3rd Infantry Division. General Eric Morella and the Air Base for the 82nd Airborne Command Team, thanks for being here today. Thank you, General Tyler Closer Group, you can come on my end over to your server. Thanks for being here today. Thank you, General Fran and Bill Cavalet. Thank you to the J-Stop DCG and the fellow Army DCG and the great friends. The former mayor, Commander of Aaron Morales, and the Sister Trail Bounds, great representatives of the family, thanks for being here today. Welcome to my family, so worried, as we have done to my non-standing and judging by my units, all of you, all of you, and my daughter Emma. I'm celebrating my son's day and could be here, and I'm being fully deployed with three qualities. My wife, 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 my wife,
$400,000 a year. He commanded 3rd Recruit Brigade, and he's also a former commander of the 119th Artillery.
Ah!
Ladies and gentlemen, the 3rd Division will now pass the interview. Crew are on the blue barrage and give respect to the national colors of their class. Thank you.
Okay, Thank you.